Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and today we're going to talk about 70-462, which is administering Microsoft SQL Server 2012 databases, and it's one of the MCSA exams for the SQL Server credential. And I'm here today with Dandy Nguyen, who's Technical Product Manager for Microsoft, and you are Johnny SQL. So tell us a little bit about yourself.
Thanks for the compliment. I started working with SQL Server a long time ago. Actually, before I came in here, I looked at when I achieved my first SQL Server certification, and that was SQL 7 back in 1999.
That's a whole millennia ago.
Yeah, exactly. So, I've been around in the database world for quite a bit, up to the point that in my day-to-day job, I'm doing databases, like I've been doing it for the longest time. And probably this certification exam, the administration of SQL Server, is probably one of my most top favorite ones because I feel, it was also my first one that I took in 99, so that was definitely something I highlight.
So then talk a little bit about what a DBA should know from a certification point of view. I mean, what makes them certified?
Yeah, I mean, so as a DBA, the thing is people look at you to make sure that your database is up and running, and that can go into high availability and performance things, but it also goes into security, right? People need to have access to their database. Their database need to be connected. They need to install SQL Server or get involved with the SQL Server installation. So a lot of DBA tasks that really come across well in the objectives for this certification exam, where we actually measure on, hey, is someone qualified as a DBA?
Yeah.
And do they know how to work with the database, maintain it, create backup jobs, and so on. So very well-designed exam.
Okay, perspective. That's good to know. So SQL is SQL, right? I mean, if I know one SQL product, I know, you know, databases are databases. Is that true?
Well, so I've got a background on Oracle, right?
Yeah.
And the way I look at it is like there definitely are differences. Of course, I would vouch for SQL Server to be the most exciting database platform in terms of things that we do with high availability, managing, monitoring, and so on. Is there a certain thing you could carry over? Yes, probably much more from the SQL language, so the structured query language and the querying stuff. From a database administration stuff, you see there's quite some differences across any kind of database platform and the tools or the capabilities that you have with SQL Server in this case to actually manage and maintain your databases.
And speaking of managing and maintaining, I mean, keeping a database up and running is probably a core function of a DBA. What does a test taker need to know about high availability?
High availability is crucial, right? Because if your database is not available, your applications will not work. So with SQL Server 2012, we introduced a feature that is always-on availability groups, which is basically an improvement to what we had called database mirroring in SQL 2005-2008.
Okay.
Always-on availability groups are using very similar concepts, but it just allows you to take multiple databases and have them fail over together. It just runs much nicer. You can have read-only copies of your database, which is something
really?
You couldn't have for database mirroring,
which
really allows you to load balance certain tasks, like why would I run my backup on a primary server if I could run it from a backup and you could offload some of that workload, which is something that definitely you're going to have to look at as a DBA when someone asks you, like, how can I increase my reporting capabilities or load data to a data warehouse, for example. Not only look at that from a high availability from that perspective, but also look at it from a performance perspective. And if there's one tip I want to give on high availability on this exam is, like, really understand what the capabilities are that you have with always-on availability groups and how to set it up, how to configure. We got some great prep videos on that as well.